Hello, welcome to the Gopalan Lab. We are located in the Engineering Research Building on the 11th floor. I'm sitting in the office right now. Our research focuses on polymers and organic materials and their self-assembly, as well as the applications of polymers in biology and some applications in soft electronics. Now we'll show you the lab. Let's check out what Jian is doing in this fume hood.
Hi, I'm Jian. I'm a fifth year now. As you know, we do a lot of polymer synthesis in our lab. What I am doing right now is a freeze pump style process for polymerization by using ATRP. We have six fume hoods in our lab, which all have the functions of doing degassing and freeze pump style process, as well as for common organic reactions.
Over here, we have our chiller. We use this for living anionic polymerization, and it goes to minus 78 degrees, as well as another fume hood right over here. In the next room, we have some more fume hoods. Let's look at what Rhee is doing in this hood.
Hello, my name is Chen. I'm a fourth-year graduate student here in Gopalan's lab. So, as you know, our work involves the synthesis of a lot of different monomers. And to purify these monomers, we use this flash column setup. This instrument can automatically set the different products from a mixture, and we can use the pure products we get for the other synthesis and the reactions.
Right here we have our rotary evaporator. We use this to remove solvents. Back there is the chiller, and right here is the pump. Here's another of our fume hoods. In this room, we have two more fume hoods, as well as our solvent tower. So in our solvent tower, we have a THF column and a toluene column, and we use this to get really pure solvents for our polymerizations. Here's our in-house GPC. We use this after our polymerizations. We perform gel permeation chromatography to characterize the molecular weight and the dispersity of our polymers. And right next to this, we have a UV vis. So this is used for UV vis absorption to characterize some of the things we make in lab. Here, we have our ice maker. This is one of our big freezers. And then we also have these vacuum oven chambers. Let's see what Fraser's doing over here.
This is our spin coater. We use it to deposit a thin film of polymer on our substrate, and then usually we take the substrate and we put it in our thermal annealing chamber here, which we use to control the temperature over a certain period of time to induce self-assembly.
And then right behind Fraser, we have our glove box. We use this for oxygen-sensitive materials because we can create an oxygen-free atmosphere inside of here. Here we have another small thermal annealing chamber since we do a lot of self-assembly in our lab. Right here we have our Langmuir-Blodgett trough. We use this to look at the pressure of amphiphiles, and we can create a monolayer of the amphiphiles and then deposit that onto our substrates. Moving this way, we have our electrochemical workstation. We can use this to look at the electrochemical properties of our materials, as well as performing electrochemical polymerization. This right here is our UV crosslinker. So this uses UV light to crosslink our materials. And then right next to it, we have our centrifuge, which we use most often to precipitate out our polymers. Thanks for visiting our lab.